February 8th, 1987. Providence, Rhode Island's own Vinny the Tasmanian Devil Pazienza scores a 10th round TKO over Roberto Elizondo. Tough, lightweight battlers became destined to meet on a collision course for the IBF crown. Almost immediately, the war of words began and was in full swing by the time of their first face-to-face meeting.
You got the title and they're putting me on the cover. I should tell you something.
April 18th, 1987, Providence. While sparring, Vinny Pazienza's nose is broken. The fight is postponed to June 7th. May 24th, the original fight date, and verbal fisticuffs continue.
You're not going to take my belt, and I'll tell you that right now. You're going to have to go back to watching Rocky movies with Daddy, okay?
Okay, Greg, we'll see you on June 7th. You just be
ready. I'll be there.
And 3 days ago, the fireworks exploded once again. And now, Greg Haugen, the champion, is just minutes away from entering the Devil's Den. Their fists will do the talking now. Live from the Providence Civic Center, it's the IBF Lightweight Championship. Today on Sports World. Center, also the home of the Friars of Providence College, who surprisingly went to the NCAA Final Four, providing much excitement in this area. Today, it is Vinny Pazienza's time in the spotlight, and this crowd has come out to root for the young man who's been labeled as the only professional sports franchise in the state of Rhode Island. Hi, everybody. Marv Albert along with the fight doctor, Freddie Pacheco. Well, all the verbal warfare has concluded. Flying around for weeks here, particularly in Providence, between Greg Haugen and Vinny Pazienza, and they're just about set to enter the ring and take care of the business inside to our right. Greg Haugen comes in with a record of 19-0-1, 9 by knockout. Vinny Pazienza, 22-1, 18 by KO. And Bernie, many boxing people feel that this has the potential to be one of the outstanding matchups of the year.
Could be the fight of the year, but many factors enter into it. Of course, the contender Pazienza, the speed and the agility of Pazienza versus the strength and determination of the champion Haugen. The fragility of the nose, it's been fractured. Pazienza had a nose fracture 7 weeks ago, maybe not enough time to get it well before this fight. And of course, this crowd, which may affect the judges with its roaring intensity. And the main quality is toughness. Whoever's toughness, it from 10 to 15 rounds, that's the guy who's going to walk out of here with the championship.
And we'll take a close-up look at the champion, Greg Haugen, in just a moment. But first, let's go to our studios in New York. Here's Bill Backer. For Greg Haugen, the American dream comes with 10-ounce leather gloves and 135 pounds of toughness.
He's Norwegian and Sioux Indian, and he was raised street tough, and he's just a tough individual. He's probably one of the toughest guys I've ever known.
And last December, he scored his biggest victory to date when he upset Jimmy Paul to capture the IBF Lightweight Championship.
Feels great to be the champion. I've worked long and hard to get it, and you know, there was times when I never thought this moment would, you know, be here, but no, I just kept plugging away at it and working.
While he now lives and trains in Las Vegas, the road to his success began in Auburn, Washington, where he was born and raised and still maintains close ties with his family and friends.
Well, I think Greg exemplifies the kind of tradition that we have here in sports. You know, local boy makes good. He's one of our own, and he's done well, and I think he brings a lot of pride to us. Everybody's always good, glad to see him when he comes back.
He began boxing in Auburn as a youngster, and from the start, his talent and toughness were apparent.
He was such a smart little guy, you know, when it come to defense, and, you know, just when you had a 6-7 year old that was still a mama's boy, and you get some 6-7-year-old that comes in there that's, you know, that absolutely is smarter than the rest of these 6-7-year-old, no mama boy whatsoever, like Greg was, well, then he's way ahead of the game to start out with.
He had a lot of leadership potential. Greg was the kind of youngster where if Greg was going to be involved with an activity, then it was marked okay by the other kids.
But Greg did not experience an easy life. Raised by his mother after his parents' divorce, his childhood was...
We all pitched in together. We couldn't have never made it otherwise.
The most important thing was to have faith. I mean, we just had a lot of hard times, but we stuck together. I mean, the bond that we have through it all. And, you know, like I've said before, it's not where we came from, it's where we're going. Okay, who
do you and family support has certainly helped Greg along the way.
I'd do anything in the world for him, just like anybody else in my family.
We've all just been behind him, pushing, and he's just got a lot of people behind him, and it just makes you more want to go for your goal. And I
in Alaska, Greg began to prove himself professionally by winning fights many expected him to lose, including a sixth-round KO over Chris Calvin. His prowess in the ring finally led to a title shot and happier times.
It made me a better fighter, I think, knowing that I had to win all these fights or I wasn't going to go nowhere.
And indeed, Greg's determination to be a success can be summed up in two words, the names of his daughters.
Jasmine and Cassandra. You got it.
And hopefully they'll know it was for them.
And his recent reconciliation with his father after a separation of many years is for Greg a personal victory.
I'm beginning to get some of that fun out of a lot of the years that I missed.
As Greg prepares for his first title defense, he exudes an air of confidence in what lies ahead of him in Providence as well as down the road.
Greg is going to go right out. He'll press him, and he'll fight like he usually does. He's a disciplined fighter. He listens. And I know Greg won't have any problem with him at all. And I'm sure the whole fight will go the way we plan it.
Well, I think there's a lot better days ahead, huh?
And Greg Haugen says he will do whatever he has to do, use his head, his gloves, elbows, whatever, to get in close enough. He will take punishment to land his punch. Not as quick as Pazienza, but very methodical in contrast to Vinny Pazienza. And we'd like to welcome those of you who have just joined us from the West Coast, Marv Albert and the fight doctor, Ferdy Pacheco. Greg Haugen and Vinny Pazienza are getting ready. And out at the Rail Tavern in Auburn, Washington, some 30 miles outside of Seattle, a host of Greg Haugen fans are watching us on the big screen up ahead. And there is Lou Gellis from NBC's affiliate King Television in Seattle. Let's get a report. Let's go to Lou.
Thank you, Marvin. Good afternoon, everyone. Yes, they're pretty excited here. If Rhode Island is Vinny, it's noisy. If Vinny is the first pro athlete and the only pro team really in Providence, well, certainly Greg Haugen has that claim here in Auburn. This is his mother. This is the family. And you can imagine what they've been doing this afternoon, getting ready for this big bout. At 10 o'clock this morning when this place opened, there was a huge line outside, wasn't there?
Yep. Yes, there was. They were waiting to get in the door at 9:30.
And now they're all here to watch the fight unfold with the rest of you. Marv?
All right, Lou. And I'm told they were serving deviled eggs, a message to Vinny Pazienza back here in Providence. And we'll be back to take a close-up look at the Pasmanian Devil after we pause for these messages.
He's so fine. She were mine.
The boxing world has always reacted to a showman. Love it or hate it, performers with a flair for the dramatic sell tickets. And Vinny Pazienza, alias the Pazmanian Devil, sells tickets. Armed with fast hands and not one to pull his verbal punches, Pazienza has catapulted into today's IBF lightweight championship. But with a world title on the line, will Pazienza tone down the act?
Sometimes I come up with the unusual, but it always works out for me. I'm well aware of what's going on. I'm aware of the crowd. I'm well aware of what I'm doing. And maybe there's times when I showboat a little bit, but that's what I do to win.
You take Sugar Ray Leonard, you take Muhammad Ali. They had a little bit of that also, understand? But they had great talent. I look for Vinny along the same lines. He's got talent. Sure, he puts on an act, but this is what the people want to see out there, and he can win with that kind of a talent.
Unaffected by reigning champion Greg Haugen's reputation as a tough guy who was able to combat the slick boxing skills of former champion Jimmy Paul, Pazienza views Haugen with disdain.
Greg Haugen, in my mind, is just a foul-mouthed punk. He's an ESPN club fighter, and I don't like him. I don't have any respect for him because of that.
Wearing his robe of confidence on the outside, Pazienza must look within himself for the stamina and drive it'll take to go 15 rounds against his toughest opponent today.
I fight with a lot of heart. Whether I'm dying on my feet after 10 rounds, I'm going to make the last five on heart alone, so I'm not worried about that. I think I can handle the pace. I've been training extremely hard. I've been boxing 12, 15 rounds every day with three different guys. I don't see 15 rounds as being a problem for me. It's more of a problem for Greg Haugen.
Now as the final seconds run down to the biggest fight of his life, Vinny Pazienza says he's ready.
I don't think Greg Haugen's going to be able to put up with all of the angles, the different moves, my speed, the power. I don't think he's going to be able to handle it through 15 rounds. If he does, he's going to need a big Tylenol when it's over, and I'll be glad to take a 15-round decision.
And back in Providence, this crowd anticipating the entrance of Vinny Pazienza, and here he comes. A dramatic entrance for the Pazmanian Devil. Get the idea, a rock star is about to enter the ring area.
Either that or a rocket ship. Something momentous is about to happen.
And that is usually the cue for Pazienza. Pazienza camp pulling out all the stops. Vinny led it to the ring by the Pazmanian Devil. Pazienza, who has predicted an 11th round knockout of Greg Haugen, while Haugen and says he will stop Pazienza in nine.
And even his shoes are covered with spangles. I haven't seen that many spangles since my wife got dressed up to the Daughters of the American Revolution ball.
Actually, for Vinny, this is a low-key outfit. We've seen more flamboyance.
But certainly must be a big hit in Italy because each one of his cornermen and Pazienza dressed in the colors of the Italian flag.
The entrance of the IBF lightweight champion, Rick Haugen. Here he comes to the streets of Bad Boy Boogie by ACDC. Rick Haugen. And back home at Auburn, Washington, Greg's mom, Sandy. And a contingent at the Rail Tavern rooting Rick Haugen on. Away from the start of the bout. Back with Haugen and Pazienza in just a moment. A crowd of 9,000 at the Civic Center in Providence. Marv Albert and the fight doctor, Ferdy Pacheco. The referee will be Wally Schmidt out of Puerto Rico. And there are the judges, Richard Bays of Miami, Keith McDonald of Carson City, Nevada, and Dr. Clark San Martino of Providence. The request made by both camps for one neutral judge, one from Providence and one from Nevada, where Haugen has been training. In fact, IBF President Bob Lee has now requested that the judges jot down one line concerning their scoring of each round, so the judges then will be accountable for their scoring. A novel thought by Bob Lee. We're set for the introductions. Let's go to Frank Carpano in the ring.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is a 15-round IBF lightweight championship bout. The judges for this fight, Richard Bays, Keith McDonald, and Clark A. San Martino. And now for the referee, the man in charge of this bout, Wally Schmidt. Now for the boxers. First, in the blue corner, the challenger, weighing in at 134 and one half pounds, from Cranston, Rhode Island,
curricular activity continues, and manager Lou Duva showing us his wrestling side, getting involved with the fighter Greg Haugen.
And in the red corner, the champion, weighing in at 134 and one quarter pound, from Auburn, Washington, Greg Haugen.
Is by the 10-point must system with the three scoring judges that you saw a moment ago. Three knockdown rule not in effect. The mandatory eight count rule is in effect. There is no standing eight, and a fighter may not be saved by the bell except in the final round. We have learned just moments ago that Vinny Pazienza, who had difficulty making the weight, is suffering with an upset stomach, something the Haugen camp is not aware of, but could change the complexion and strategy of this bout.
And that's what a championship fight's all about, how you handle the stress. If he ate too much or drank too much fluids, then the stomach does get upset and he could become weaker. He's certainly not in the introduction.
Nose to nose go Haugen and Pazienza.
To cap that remains to be seen. So much of that happens in the dressing room in the first round, and you will not know until a fight starts and progresses how that will affect Vinny Pazienza. So on to the first round.
And this is round one, scheduled for 15.
You would have to search your memory to hear the kind of ovation that the challenger got, and no ovation for the championship. For the challenger, of course, it's his hometown. The champion is used to that.
So much has been said prior to the fight, an effort to sell tickets. And there have been some insults concerning the city of Providence that Greg Haugen has offered. And Vinny Pazienza has certainly done his share in that department concerning Haugen and the state of Washington.
A little rough sub, and it's stopped immediately by Wally Schmidt.
And the major concern from the Pazienza point of view has to be that broken nose that Pazienza suffered 7 weeks ago, and you can look for Haugen to try to jab away at it, move inside, and then quickly get out.
Well, of course, I think the Pazienza camp is almost resigned to the fact that it will re-break and it will bleed through this foul.
Good left hand by Pazienza.
Pazienza, while he is fresh, should dominate the early rounds because of his speed and superior boxing skill. It's in the later rounds where the going is going to get tough for young Vinny Pazienza.
And Haugen lifted by Pazienza after he landed. Some hot dogging attempted by Pazienza in this opening round.
Of course, if there's one guy that's not going to go for hot dog, and it's Haugen. Grimly determined, set, and ready to fight 15 rounds is Greg Haugen.
And Haugen scoring with the jab. At the bottom of your screen, the Haugen family watching intently back at Auburn, Washington.
And the champion Haugen not doing badly for himself this first round. Certainly, Vinny is not outspeeding him as much as he thought he would.
Good exchange as we come up on 10 seconds to go in this opening round. Be back with round two after this word. Watch this at the end of round one. Pazienza and Haugen giving each other a facial nose to nose. On to round two.
Haugen will do anything to get to that fragile nose of Vinny Pazienza.
How'd you score the first round?
Very close, but to Vinny Pazienza because of superior boxing skill and simply the number of punches that landed. But it's much closer than I anticipated. Haugen doesn't look as slow as I thought he would. And certainly fighting back with a lot of determination.
Haugen in the blue. Pazienza in the white. And Haugen continues to snap the jab.
That's it, punch it, baby.
Between rounds, Pazienza was told in his corner, you gotta box this guy. Don't fool around.
Google once said to him, you got to make this easy. I'll holler, touch him, means jab and run. That's easy, but you got to fight. This is for the championship.
A lot of conversation in the ring between the two.
And the first little dribble of blood has just come out of Vinny Pazienza's nose, as expected.
Break me out. Go, Vinny!
Over the right brow of Pazienza. Looks like it's the start of a cut.
Nice combination from Haugen. Left hand by Haugen that landed. Pazienza back with the right.
This, of course, just what Haugen wants. He wants a roughhouse. He wants to go head-to-head with him.
Under a minute to go. Round two. It's for the IBF Lightweight Championship. Haugen defending his title for the first time.
And Haugen landing the best punch of the fight so far.
Haugen,
Lou Duva has tried to caution Vinny Pazienza, don't fight even if you get hit. Just keep bipping and bopping. Of course, you can't do that to a young man like Vinny Pazienza in front of his hometown. He will explode.
Pazienza shifting, and Haugen saying, no, it doesn't work. And Haugen reaching out to connect with the left. Final seconds. Second round. And a strong round for Haugen.
Okay. And he's walking in behind you.
Hey. You can't feel good, he's mine.
Okay. Hey.
You got him.
All right, you got this here now?
Yeah. Hey.
Let me see. Come here.
There's that left hook by Haugen. Pazienza trying to counter. Vinny Pazienza suffering with a couple of nicks over the first two rounds. He actually has not been cut or nicked the last four fights, but he was either cut or nicked in the previous five.
Something is causing a discoloration. It's not quite a cut. I don't know if it's something coming off his trunks. He's got so many red spangles and things. A moment it looked like it was a cut opening up, but that is not materialized. Or the gloves themselves, the coloring off the gloves. Of course, what's coming from his nose is not coloring, but blood. And that's just the natural sequela of a broken nose five or seven weeks ago. 7 weeks, I think they go.
Opening minute, round three. This is scheduled for 15. Haugen's last fight last December in Las Vegas in a surprise and a 15-round decision over Jimmy Paul to win the IBF lightweight crown. Pazienza continues to wind up looking for that big right hand, but has not been able to make contact.
Vinny's not fighting an intelligent fight. Pazienza's not fighting the fight that he planned for or that Lou Duva laid out for him. He's fighting a sort of, if you want to use the word, semi-hysterical fight. He's going in two different ways. He's not coordinating his action, but Haugen looks completely calm and in control. He's fighting the kind of fight he wants to fight. And he's got to settle down. This is a 15-round fight. He now has got to go back, circling around, popping that jab. That is Pazienza's fight right there. Quick move. Frustrate Haugen.
Less than a minute to go. Third round.
Vinny comes off the rope with a sneaky right hand that nails Haugen, except that it doesn't have anything on it.
See a lot of movement, a lot of flair, but Haugen has been out-punching Pazienza. In Haugen's hometown in Auburn, Washington. Checking out the action.
Great uppercut by Pazienza a moment ago.
And we've come to the end of the third round. The last title fight here in Providence was back in May of 1983. Marvin Hagler and Wilfred Cipion. Hagler retaining his middleweight title with a fourth round knockout of Cipion. This is for the IBF lightweight championship. Haugen defending his title against Pazienza. Marv Albert and the fight doctor, Ferdy Pacheco. Well, what does the fight doctor scorecard tell us?
Extremely close fight, 29-28 in Pazienza's favor. But each round has been a very close affair. Be interesting to see what the commentary will be on the judges' scorecards as they try to capture each round.
Now come on, finish.
certainly the expected and looked for outclassing of Haugen by the speedier Pazienza has not materialized. With a great deal of patience, almost as if he's savoring what's to come after round 10.
Referee Wally Schmidt from Puerto Rico. Halfway through round 4. The shifting of Pazienza looking to throw Haugen off stride, but to this point it has not worked. Because Pazienza did land on Haugen off that last exchange. Haugen laughing and taunting Pazienza. Seconds of the fourth round. We'll be back here in Providence after this. And there is Greg Haugen out for round number 5. Haugen says he's never been knocked down. He said the only time he was hurt was in the first round of his fight against Chris Calvin. He got caught early, said he came out lazy with his hands down, but he did come back and came up with a victory. Greg Haugen at 19-0-1. 9 by knockout. Vinny Pazienza comes in at 22-1, 18 by KO. Last February, Pazienza stopping Roberto Elizondo in the 10th round here in Providence. Haugen's last bout last December, and a surprise, he won by decision over Jimmy Paul to win the IBF lightweight crown. Pazienza's dad, Angelo, who from time to time can't get a bit overexcited. Crowd trying to get Pazienza going.
Pazienza has been fighting the fight he wants for the last 2 or 3 rounds in boxing, showing a lot of defensive skills and trying to neutralize the counterpunching of Greg Haugen. Greg has been doing very well counterpunching, however, and the rounds have been awfully close.
What do you have it on the scorecard?
Unofficially, of course, Vinny Pazienza had 39-37. But each round by just a slim margin. Usually the boxing ability, defensive ability of Vinny Paz, and because he's fighting his fight, not Greg Haugen's right now. He's settled down, contrary to what was happening to him in the first 2 rounds where he was fighting an excited fight.
Pazienza able to muscle Haugen to the ropes. Haugen plays peekaboo and is able to slip away.
Haugen truly looks like he's just biding his time. He's content to make these rounds close. Some may well have gone to the champion and wait for the later rounds.
Oh, left hand by Haugen got in on Pazienza. Crowd roaring, but not much happened from Pazienza's point of view. Vinny Pazienza, who from time to time will use the ropes, a no-no.
I don't think he's going to do it much on Wally Smith.
The capital city of Rhode Island on to round six. Rick Haugen defending his IBF lightweight title against Vinny Pazienza. And Pazienza effectively doubling up and then tied up by Haugen.
What a holding and hitting right then. Wally Smith having a tough time with these two small men getting him apart. That's the kind of fight that's in Greg Haugen's favor. Toughest fight, he told me, was against a grizzly bear in a tough man competition in Atlanta. This guy is tough. This Greg Haugen is a tough kid.
Well, he began his pro career in November of 84 after building up a reputation in those tough guy contests in Alaska, taking on 200-pound lumberjacks and pipeline workers. Started at $50 a shot and worked his way up to $1,000 per victory. And he became a drawing card in the tough guy contest.
He's got one of those broad Slavic faces that looks like George Chavala. He's got those long, broad, flat cheekbones. Certainly, if he can take a punch like George Chavala, boy, he's going to be some fighter for years to come.
A miniature version. Rick Haugen made great strides through a five-month span back in 85 and 86 to earn the title shot against Jimmy Paul by coming up with knockout wins over the likes of Freddie Roach and Chris Calvin, Tolly White Lightning Brown. Crowd overreacting because Pazienza just crazed Haugen.
But he just got nailed right then. Did Pazienza. Haugen nailed him with two punches in the crowd. Ooh.
Frank, stand back. Come on. Come on. Give me this. Stop holding up. Come on.
Very little body punching going on here. Both men headhunting.
Haugen caught Pazienza.
The nose now starting to bleed. A lot of blood across the face. Pazienza, that's that broken nose. It may well have been rebroken.
And there will be concern in the corner of Vinny Pazienza. Will stay right here between rounds. Haugen again with the short right hand.
Haugen now connecting with a great deal of force with his counter punches. Depends on how Vinny reacts to this blood and the fact that his nose may well be broken again. While it's painful, it does not stop you from fighting.
In the corner of Vinny Pazienza, there are count of two cut men, and Ace Marotta, Joey Fariello.
Nice and easy.
There's no cut.
He's cut. Let's, Vinny. Vinny, look. He is. His nose is all busted up now. It's starting to bust open on him. Vinny, look. What you got to do with this guy here, Vinny, you're giving him too much room. You're giving him. You're walking in and you're running after him. I want you to jab your way and jab his chest and then take off. Now, on the reaction punches, you're not doing good. On the reaction, I want you to see you take off. Okay? Now, come on.
Come on, kid.
Right?
Listen to these.
Jab his head, jab his, and go to work on his body. Okay? Let me see you get low.
Give him some water, bro.
Come on.
Big left hand by Haugen. But in the corner of Vinny Pazienza, Lou Duva telling Pazienza that Haugen's nose may be busted up.
Yeah, back him up, back him, hit him in the chest. Right, turn him, turn him.
Round seven, scheduled for 15. Pazienza on the attack. Haugen indicating no problem as Pazienza attempts to step up the action.
While Pazienza looks much flashier, his punches in the last two rounds are short. They're not landing. That's why Haugen is making fun of him. They're just not landing. They're not hurting Greg Haugen. And Haugen has been very effective in counterpunching. The look on Greg Haugen's face is one of a man that's enjoying himself in this afternoon. He just looks like he's having fun. This will make breathing difficult. It will also make him nauseated in time as he swallows the blood.
All very pleasant thoughts. Pazienza landed the right hand to stun Haugen. A lunging right hand that set Haugen back. Coming up on a minute to go, seventh round.
Vinny's punches, even his hardest ones, don't seem to have a great effect on Haugen. He's willing to take two or three shots to land some of those hammering counter punches of his. He's fighting a measured fight.
Earlier, Pazienza was getting hit consistently with the left hook of Haugen, and Pazienza was told, stop dropping the right hand.
Which was looked for because of his difficulties in the dressing room right before the fight.
We were told that Pazienza, who had trouble making the weight, also was suffering with an upset stomach.
That's it. Great.
Final seconds, seventh round. Concern in the corner of Greg Haugen. Check out the cut under the eye.
So Haugen now cut under the left eye, which will not affect the contest under the eye. And Pazienza with a possible broken nose. And both men beginning to show the effects of this battle, which is heating up.
And much confidence being shown here by Vinny Pazienza, opening up with that combination a moment ago, although Haugen laughed it off. And for the first time, you get a sense of one of the boxers taking command.
A lot of heads going on there, a lot of butting going on, a lot of elbows. Wally Schmidt is going to have to start taking command when they get in close because it's getting dirty.
Opening minute, round eight, scheduled for 15 for the IBF lightweight title.
And roughly midway through, we have this thing roughly even in the scoring, 66 to 65, slight edge to the champion, Haugen.
Up to date on the Fight Doctor scorecard.
It's almost an even fight. Good combination by Pazienza. And it's 66 to 65, Greg Haugen. As Haugen has begun to slip ahead.
Effectively following the good start by Pazienza at the beginning of this eighth round.
Vinny Pazienza is fighting this fight as if it were a 10-round fight. This is 15. Greg is taking his time. Vinny's laying it all out. Will he have enough in the tank to go between 10 and 15? That we will see.
Pazienza has never gone 15. Haugen has. In fact, he did in his last fight when he beat Jimmy Paul to win the lightweight title.
This is round nine. Marv Albert and the fight doctor, Ferdy Pacheco, from Providence, Rhode Island. Vinny Pazienza fighting in his hometown. Rick Haugen in the blue. Pazienza in the white. Pazienza opened up the eighth round very impressively. And Haugen came back strong.
It's one of those rounds that Pazienza won, but you're afraid that he paid a bigger price than Greg Haugen. Because Haugen's punches toward the end were sharp and destructive to Vinny Pazienza.
Ringside. The rest of the family is back home in Auburn, Washington.
Vinny willing to rest. Vinny willing to rest his round. And Greg Haugen willing to let him rest around.
Halfway through the ninth round. Again, the heads come together.
As he enters with that left hand down low, as he will do from time to time.
When he puts that hand down, he's got plenty of distance between the two fighters, so he has plenty of time to bring it up by the time Greg makes his assault.
It is now Haugen who is establishing the tempo.
Come on, take off.
Well, the crowd trying to get into it with the chant for Vinny Pazienza. They were restless earlier in the round. Not much action taking place. Well, backhand swipe by Pazienza. So we go on to round 10 after these messages. Back in Providence, Rhode Island, Greg Haugen and Vinny Pazienza out for round 10 on NBC Sports World.
Having rested and blown the round, Vinny Pazienza comes out steaming.
Does not seem to be suffering any from that cut that he took earlier under the left eye.
Well, it was well handled. It was never going to be a factor in a fight being under the eye.
Questions still remain concerning that broken nose suffered 7 weeks ago by Pazienza.
Well, it certainly looks like from the bleeding and the swelling that it's broken again. However, no broken nose ever stopped the fight because it's just not the nature of that injury.
As the answer nearly got caught.
Right back, baby!
scoring with the jab, and Pazienza countered with the left. Now that jab has been very effective for Greg Haugen.
And Haugen looks as confident as he did in the first round. Sort of waiting his time for this flashy kid to wind down. Now, Vinny Pazienza has been winding down in the last three or four rounds.
Lou Duva screaming from the corner of Pazienza. Box, box. And he lands on the combination. Followed up by that right hand. To go, 10th round. Civic Center in Providence, Rhode Island. Greg Haugen defending his IBF lightweight crown. Edwin Rosario is the WBA lightweight champ. And it'll be Jose Luis Ramirez going against Terrence Ali for the vacant title of, was held by Hector Camacho in the WBC. Strong finish by Pazienza in the 10th round. First time that Pazienza has gone past the 10. Haugen has been there before.
Vinny's back to the cat and mouse game to while away the minutes. Haugen has been able to fight his fight, to wait patiently for counter-punching opportunities, and to hammer at the nose of Vinny Pazienza. And I have this a unofficially even fight at 95-95. And it is, of course, for the championship at the, and at this point from here on out is where they're going to go.
To life, but Pazienza's combination had little effect on Haugen. Scoring on the 10-point must system, handled by the three judges, one from Providence, one from Nevada, where Haugen trains, and then the neutral judge, Richard Bays, out of Miami.
Pazienza having one of his better rounds this time, deciding in the 11th round to go after him. Haugen has not changed the stroke. And this, we may be winding into one of these very interesting judging decisions, because there's a wildly separate opinion of the press behind us, some of whom have Haugen winning by a wide margin, and others have Pazienza winning. So we may be winning another one of those afternoons. Maybe we should just ask the guy from Miami. Yeah.
That is the neutral judge. Which is a commentary on boxing, that the others are not considered neutral. Back on to round 12. Interesting dialogue a moment ago in the corner. Greg Haugen, his trainer Stan Tistis, says you better go all out from here on in. Haugen said, why am I losing? And Tistis said, no, but they'll rob you here.
You know, I'm often wondering about that, if you got judges from someplace else. But of course, the crowd does play a part in the emotions of the judges. We weren't supposed to have any, but that's just malarkey.
opening up big every one of these rounds. Good hook by Pazienza. Winging hook from nowhere. And now, all of a sudden, Greg Haugen too laid back. And if he lets these rounds slip away from him, he can let his title slip away from him. His corner is not wrong. He has to start winning these rounds convincingly.
Step by, fighting.
Holy shit. Halfway through. Round 12. Did not have the full effect. Haugen saying, no, you're not bothering me. These are the kind of rounds that Pazienza needs to take this title from Greg Haugen. And Vinny Pazienza now playing games with Greg Haugen, which can be dangerous.
But he can afford to play away this last 30 seconds.
And Pazienza getting in with the right, winding up with the polo punch. And caught Haugen with the left.
What a charge by Vinny Pazienza.
And Pazienza hearing it from the crowd as this 12th round comes to a close. The crowd here in Providence roaring as Pazienza and Haugen move to the center of the ring. A very strong 12th round for Vinny Pazienza. Pazienza in the white. And is scheduled for 15. And again, Pazienza scoring with the right hand.
Pazienza's punches are now accurate where they have been wild, and they're strong. Haugen's corner beginning to show real concern that he could lose his title here.
What do you have it on the scorecard?
I have Vinny Pazienza ahead 115-113.
But a wide range of opinions in terms of the scoring here at ringside as we check the media. Scoring on the 10-point must system.
No question that the crowd is that extra oomph that Vinny Pazienza needs.
And the crowd reacting as Pazienza is able to slip punches very effectively.
Using the strand of rope as a sort of spring. He just went back and forth. Big welt under the left eye of Vinny Pazienza.
And Greg Haugen's mom back in Auburn, Washington, spending some difficult moments with Pazienza coming on strong the last couple of rounds. Less than a minute to go, round 13.
Pazienza showing some signs of weariness from that three-round charge that he's been on.
Pazienza's left eye also closing. And that could turn things.
Pazienza's hand resting wearily on that top round.
That top rope and that left welt that we mentioned has now closed Vinny Pazienza's eye. A trickle of blood emanating from the corner of the eye.
And as we come to the end of round 13, Pazienza may be in a situation where he will need a knockout. That eye is closing, and this fight has turned again.
Hey, Vinny, you got to punch with two hands, right?
Yep.
You got to slip and you got to punch. Make him pay for these slips. You got this?
Please.
Now, what you're doing, you're getting lazy out there. Okay? You got two rounds, 6 minutes. Baby, you win your title. Let's go.
Six lousy minutes, and we got it, baby. Come on, let's go.
Hey.
And we're headed to round 14 in the corner of Pazienza. He was being told the left eye is no problem, but it is closing.
Well, it's virtually closed as far as vision is concerned. It's just a slit. And he's in a big problem. He can't see out of one eye, and he can't breathe out of his nose. And that's what you call trouble in boxing.
And this is a very difficult fight to score. There's no telling what is written on the judges' scorecard. Richard Bays from Miami, Keith McDonald out of Carson City, Nevada, Dr. Clark Sammartino from here in Providence.
Vinny being told he needs these two rounds to win the fight. And that's an understatement. He certainly does. Well, win or lose, Vinny Pazienza has certainly shown that he's not just a piece of fluff. He's a tough, tough kid.
And the same for Greg Haugen, who comes in as the IBF lightweight champ off the win over Jimmy Paul last December.
Haugen is virtually unmarked. And Vinny looks like he ran into a Mack truck.
Haugen had the nick under the left eye earlier, but that has provided no problem. From Haugen.
That's the way these rounds go, just flipping back and forth. Just when you think Pazienza's back in command, back comes the champion Haugen.
Pazienza succeeding with the uppercut. A minute left. Round 14.
Neither man willing to concede an inch through every one of these rounds. Good punch with nothing on it. Still a point getter for Pazienza. It just may be that the superior hand speed of Vinny Pazienza putting in two, three, and four punches instead of one will win these rounds for him. But they're close because the meaningful punches are being landed by Greg Haugen.
After the bell, and we'll stay right here. 15th and final round coming up.
It's the last round, I think. What round is this? 15th. You got to knock him out this round to win.
Not aware of the round that Stan Tischler and the corner of Greg Haugen.
And Stan said the last round, and you got to knock him out to win.
Showing great concern with the judges' scorecard. That's Greg's mom in the Rail Tavern.
Yeah, I got this one.
Bring him back.
Don't stop punching.
Talk to me for many minutes.
Right. Okay.
Don't stop punching.
Vinny, you got to get that jab in and out on the side, but you got to go with two hands. You got to go with this guy. It's 3 minutes of the world champion of the world. Come on, 3 minutes.
And this crowd trying to break. provide the spark for the hometown favorite, Vinny Pazienza. 15th and final round. What do you have it on the scorecard?
I've got it 143 to 133. Vinny Pazienza by 1 point.
You mean 134
by 133. I'm sorry.
All right, that's the Fight Doctor scorecard. Scoring on the 10-point must. And we're opening minute, final round.
Face a bloody mask now and a mask of exhaustion. Vinny is drawing a big breath from his mouth. He can't breathe through his nose. He can't see out of one eye. And on comes Vinny Pazienza.
And we are halfway through this final round. Greg Haugen defending his IBF lightweight crown.
And what a great show by both fighters, as neither one has been willing to give up an inch. There goes a volley and a rally by Pazienza. Those are the ones that give him the points to take this last round.
And a brawling conclusion.
Vinny too tired to take advantage.
Combination by Haugen. We're under a minute to go in the 15th. So it has come down to the final half minute. Greg Haugen and Vinny Pazienza. So they go the distance. Greg Haugen and Vinny Pazienza go 15 for the IBF lightweight title. We'll be back with the decision in a moment. The scene here at the Civic Center in Providence, crowd of 9,000 on hand. Vinny Pazienza, Greg Haugen going the 15 rounds. Haugen looking to defend his IBF lightweight championship, his first defense of the title. First time that Vinny Pazienza has gone 15 rounds. And we are awaiting the decision. The judges, Keith McDonald from Carson City, Nevada, Dr. Clark Sammartino of Providence, Rhode Island, and Richard Bays, considered as the neutral judge from Miami, Florida. And as we mentioned earlier, the request was made by both camps for one so-called neutral judge, and then one from Providence and one from Nevada. And IBF President Bob Lee was able to work it out. He also has now requested that the judges jot down a line or two concerning their scoring each round. He wants a capsule so the judges then would be accountable for their scoring when you look back after the fight. Greg Haugen comes in at 19-0-1, and Vinny Pazienza at 22-1. Concern on the faces of the Haugen family. Back in Auburn, Washington, we are set for the decision. Let's go to the ring. Here's Frank Carpano.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have a unanimous decision.
And apparently there's some confusion in the ring. Both Haugen and Pazienza's people lining up for the proper photograph angle, I would assume. And that's the referee, Wally Schmidt, who is prepared
and gentlemen, a unanimous
to lift the
decision.
Hand of the winner.
It's Judge Clark San Martino scores it 144 to 141. Judge Richard Bay scores it 144-141. Judge Keith McDonald scores it 144 to 142 for the winner and new IBF lightweight title holder, Vinny the Tasmanian Devil, Pazienza.
And that the scene back in Greg Haugen's hometown in Auburn, Washington, as a new IBF lightweight champion has been crowned. It is Vinny Pazienza, a decision that will be widely discussed. Very difficult fight to score. And there are many here on press row who had it in Haugen's favor. A tough defeat for Haugen, and Vinny Pazienza has won himself a championship. And a classy move by Greg Haugen. Now, these two went at each other pretty good verbally the last few weeks. And Haugen over to congratulate Vinny Pazienza. Gutty effort by both Pazienza and Haugen. So Vinny Pazienza is now the IBF lightweight champion. Right at the start, we mentioned that it had the potential to be one of the outstanding matchups of the year, and it was a terrific fight. Let's go to the ring. Here's the fight doctor with the new champion.
Congratulations, a wonderful finish.
Ready. Thank you very much. I did this for all the people who support me, all the Pazmaniacs all over the world. I got the best fans anywhere, and I didn't only do it for them. I did it for all you brilliant sports writers who keep writing the stupidest things about me.
All right, the nose, when did it break?
I think I heard it in the third or fourth round. But Freddie, like I told you before, I wouldn't be stopped today. No matter what, I kept going. Greg's a tough, tough son of a gun. He hit me with some hard shots. I can take a punch. I'm for real. It's time for everybody to wake up. I'm the new kid on the block.
Would it surprise you to know that a lot of the sports writers behind me had Haugen winning big?
Well, no, I think it was a close fight. It could have gone either way. I give Greg a lot of credit. He was in tremendous shape. I was thankful I got the shot. And I'm going to be a good champion. I'm going to defend it successfully, and I'm not going to lose. Make no two mistakes. I'm undefeated, and I'm the new champion of the world.
Congratulations, Vinny.
Mark, Kenny Weldon, all my support in Texas. I love it.
Thank you, and back to Marv Albert at ringside.
All right, the new IBF lightweight champion, Vinny Pazienza. He mentioned he's undefeated. There has been some discussion about one particular loss that has yet to be clarified, a loss that took place in Europe. So we have him as 23-1, 18 by knockout. The 24-year-old out of Cranston, Rhode Island, Vinny Pazienza, walking away with the title. Now, Ferdy is alongside the former champ, Greg Haugen.
A disappointed Greg Haugen. Did you think you could win here in Providence?
Well, I thought I could. I thought the fight was real close, you know, but I didn't think they were going to give it to me on a close fight. You know, the kid fought a hell of a fight. He fought tough, and, you know, I had trouble cutting the ring off on him. He ran a lot. But I'll give him a lot of credit. He's a tough kid. You know, I hope to have a rematch.
Did you think that he could maintain that pace through round 10 to 15? He seemed to pick up in action then.
Well, I didn't pick it up like I should have. You know, I had a little bit of a mental lapse. I should have listened to my corner a little more. And, you know, I got caught up in the fans. And, you know, he never really did hit me hard and hurt me. You know, and as you can see, he was missing a lot of punches. You know, you guys thought he was just going to punch your hell
you
out
of you. You say he was cooked. You were caught up by the fans. Do the fans, do they influence you in a title fight?
Well, they obviously influence the judges. I thought I had to rally back every time he rallied. And I thought I did good. You know, I thought I rallied back when he rallied. You know, I never really let him steal one round really big.
You know, but I fought a tough fight, and so did he. I give my heart out, so.
It was indeed a very tough fight and a great disappointment for you. I'm sure it was a fight that was so close that all of ringside had it, most for you and most for Vinny. You couldn't tell which was which, and so disappointed Greg Haugen. There'll be other days, and back to Marv Albert at ringside.
Okay, Ferdy, and while we have a moment, we'd like to extend our very best to NBC boxing producer Peter Rolf, who's done a superb job as a producer here on NBC boxing telecast since back in 1979. This is Peter's finale today. He's moving on, taking over as executive producer for Raycom Sports, and we wish him great success at Raycom. We'll be right back. Well, people back here at the Civic Center of Providence still buzzing about what they saw. The win by Vinny Pazienza by unanimous decision, taking the IBF lightweight title. What's next for Pazienza?
I think a very long rest to let that nose heal from 3 to 4 months. And then they're talking Boom Boom Mancini, Hector Camacho. I think he would have to have an easier fight than that. But Paz back to fighting by October at least.
All right, for the fight doctor, Ferdy Pacheco, this is Marv Albert saying so long.
Continues his march to a title fight. Today, though, Cooper will have to withstand the test of the truth. Carl the Truth Williams, that is, in a battle of legitimate heavyweight contenders.
Father's Day, young...